La Casa de Papel, or Money Heist, is back, except with Koreans. In the spin-off, La Casa de Papel Korea Joint Economic Area. I was extremely skeptical at this, given that it combines two cash cows of Netflix, the Money Heist franchise and the Korean hype. So I was expecting a lazy cash grab. And honestly, it is not as bad as I thought it would be. In fact, I can't even say it's bad at all. Having seen this story before, I was surprised by how I was still able to sit through the entire season. In fact, while I'm usually pretty skeptical of people saying Korean stuff is better, I think this is a better show than the original. And with original, I mean the first two parts. I don't mean the entire Spanish show, I mean the first two parts before Netflix decided to make it a cash cow and make it suck. Yes, I genuinely believe this is, objectively speaking, a better show than the amazing original Casa de Papel. So let's go over all the things done different and better than the original that this one is based on. To start off, the casting is really amazing. Some characters are really close to their original selves. So much that the first shot where I saw Moscow, I knew immediately it was him. I laughed my eyes out. Really. But if there's anything I didn't like about La Casa de Papel, even in its original run, it is that the characters of Tokyo and Berlin annoyed the living life out of me. Tokyo was a tempered, insufferable brat, and Berlin annoyed me with his pretentious attempt at philosophy, which just felt like the writers wanted to share some sour thoughts. And in general, I think the character was just annoying. And let me say, both characters are far more tolerable in this new Korean version. They're even likable. Tokyo, played by Yoon Young-so, also known as the creepy girl from The Call, she's just amazing. On one end, she has that crazy, dangerous energy that the original Tokyo had. I mean, she was Young-suk in The Call. But she behaves like a decent, tolerable, and sympathetic character for the most part. I was actually rooting for her, something I would not expect to happen, given how much I hated her in the original. And I love the change they made, where Ryo is into her, but she rejects him instead. It makes her seem much more rational and dedicated, and less emotion-driven to not just shack up with the young guy before the heist even begins. It makes me feel like she actually cares about the professor's vision, and cares about this heist succeeding. Berlin, I still wasn't a big fan of the character. He's inherently made to antagonize the other gang members, but he was far more tolerable when played by Park Hae-so, also known as the guy who went to SNU. There was no time spent on pointless philosophy essays, and his character sounded a lot cooler in Korean language. The Spanish Berlin just infuriates me when he opens his mouth. This Berlin also has a backstory that isn't shoved in your face to make you sympathize with him, but it is shown just enough to understand why the character became the way he is, other than that he's just a sociopath. The other characters are okay. I like how Ryo has a personality besides being in love with Tokyo. He's a problem child, but it is never made obnoxious in the show. And I like the professor as well. He's a bit more vulnerable and less prepared for everything, but that's fine with me. Lastly, I think that the North Korean Captain Cha from the task force is a nice addition. He's a lot cooler and better bouncing off of the main negotiator than An Chiao ever was. If there's any character here I find worse, it is Denver. The original Denver was an abrasive guy, but still likable. He had honor. This Denver seems like he only cares about getting some from Mi-soon or Monica, and acts really annoying. I also think the story is just kind of better. The pacing is faster because there's less episodes, and while most of it copies the story from the original, I think the small changes made, like with the cop infiltrating, are really well done. Another reason why the show didn't bore me despite having seen it before is that I think that the visuals are a lot better here, especially in the office at the bank. The color scheme is really pleasing on the eye compared to the brown reddish palette seen everywhere in the original. And I really like that the show doesn't rely on conflict between North and South Koreans or political messages about the evils of the other side, but rather about cooperation between them, both with the gang and with the task force. Since this is a South Korean series, it could have easily developed into a generic tale about the evil North Koreans threatening the poor Southerners. But no, the actual narrator or protagonist, Tokyo, is a North Korean who did leave North Korea to migrate to the South, but also experienced a lot of problems there, which is a real problem, given how North Korean defectors often do end up in poverty and get treated poorly in the South. The characters aren't constantly condemning the other side, but are rather trying to solve the conflict between them and see what they have in common, because they are just one people in the end, with one language and one culture historically. So yeah, I think La Casa de Papel Korea Joint Economic Area is superior to the original Spanish season it was based on. However, I didn't enjoy seeing it as much as I did with the original, because despite making some really good changes, most of the story is pretty much the same as the original. So many plot points are a bit predictable if you've seen the original show. I get that some bits are the same, you have to have the same character models and setup, but I don't see why you would make a new version for the fans of the original a few years after the original came out, while copying so many plot points points in the middle of the story from the original. The trajectory is a bit different, and I hope the next season will take it far away from the original, but from what I've seen, the plot is largely still the same. And while the problem of unlikable characters from the original show is fixed, they don't fix the other issue I have with the original series, the low stakes. When you make a show with so many life-threatening scenarios and violence, to have few to no actual deaths make it feel kind of pointless and predictable. Oh, characters in a life-threatening scenario gets wounded or whatever. Chances are 90% that they survive anyways. Hostages especially are never in any real danger. And that is really irritating. I think it would be a very strong subversion if in this version Misun or Monica was actually executed, for instance. So to end this video, I think that La Casa de Papel Korea, Joint Economic Area, is far superior to the original. It surprised me how good it was, for something that felt like a cash grab, to be honest. But on the other hand, I also wonder why they didn't make a lot more changes to the story than they already did. For people who've seen the original, like me. That being said, if you have never seen La Casa de Papel, the original, and you want to get into the show, yeah, I'd say watch this version instead and have an even better experience than I had watching the original. A non-spoiled experience.